Crackerjack!
Here's the time of the first game. Let's meet the girls. And what's your name?
Rachel.
Which school do you come from, Rachel?
College School in Teddington.
Right, from the college school. What's your name?
Mandy.
Lisa.
Lisa.
Emma.
Emma. Okay, Emma, we're going to find out how to make some animals from fruit, and to show us how to do it is Val Jackson.
Well, we're going to make this rather strange animal. It's sort of half bird, only as birds have 2 feet. You can't get it to stand on 2 feet, so we've got to give it 4 feet, and it's made out of toothpicks. You see, I'm putting 4 toothpicks in for it to stand on. And when you've got it standing nicely, you jab a hole in the back there, and you pop that little bit of foliage into the hole, if you can find it there, for its tail. And then you give it 2 toothpicks for its neck, because you've got to keep it supported while it's... You could put that through there like that. And that's its head. Yes, I hope it's its head. It doesn't seem to want to stay too much. And then you can put one through there like that, with a couple of currants on it for its eyes. There we are. There's its eyes. And you finish it off with a beak. And there you have this sort of bird animal.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you, Val. Thank you. Easy?
Easy.
Come on, let's have a try, Em, and Val will come back and mark you out of 20. Over this way, girls, please. Lisa there, Rachel there, Mandy there, and Emma at the end. And I've got me whistle with me this week, all ready to blow. You've got 45 seconds, starting from... That's it. Remember, they've got to have 4 legs, these birds. That's just about it. Yes, that's all. But you've all done very, very well. I think you had a difficult job here, Val. You'd like to come and mark Lisa first of all. There's Lisa's lovely little animal. Why, she's a birdie.
Yes, collapsed a bit. Shall we give that 12?
12 out of 20. Very good for Lisa. There's Rachel.
Yes, that's nice. I'm afraid that collapsed a bit too. Shall we give that 13?
13. She's got a headache in there. There we go. Next one for Mandy.
Well, Mandy, that's a lovely one. I think we ought to give that, 17.
17.
Yes. And I think 16, because it's only got one eye.
Oh, so Mandy beats Emma. Mandy's the winner. Well done, so we'll see Mandy later on at the end of the programme. Thank you, Jan. She's got, of course, everybody's prize, that lovely pen with the inscription, Crackerjack! Well, there have been one or two mysterious things happening lately, so I'd better go over and ask Bernie and Jan exactly what's been happening.
Know where Pete is. He's nowhere around here.
I know. I've looked at his dressing room and his suit hasn't been slept in all day.
You must admit, he has been acting rather strange lately.
I know. And you know, we've been getting letters from viewers saying the same thing.
You don't think we should inform the police, do you?
There's no point. It's the police that wrote the letters.
I mean, he could be wandering around with amnesia.
Oh, he's probably taking it to the pictures.
Oh. Amnesia is a loss of memory.
Oh, I see.
Oh,
what's that?
I wonder what he's doing with this hanging around here.
Oh, it's probably one of his crazy lectures. Let's have a look. Now, why would Peter leave a thing like that in the middle of the studio?
I don't know. Ah! Oh!
Wouldn't you like to know, eh? Well, as a matter of fact, that has been left there in order to prove to you two ignoramuses that I'm about to take my correct position in society.
We've been double glazed.
Rent-a-nut?
Rent-a-nut? What do you mean, rent-a-nut? Certainly not. I might tell you that is the prototype of a sculpture that is being made of me. I am going on view to the public.
Ah, why not? You've been making an exhibition of yourself for years.
Peter, do you mean to say that we have got to spend 10p every time we want to have a look at you?
10p? 10p, madam? Wouldn't even get you into the foyer of Madame Tussauds. Oh.
Madame Tussauds, at last, they've got you in the Chamber of Horrors.
Not at all. I expect to go in to the Hall of Celebrity. Yes. As a matter of fact, I had a fitting only today.
What, for the rack of the guillotine?
Certainly not. My word. The young lady who sculpted me, as a matter of fact, said she thought that I had the perfect figure for modelling.
Yeah, garden gnomes and Toby jugs.
That's going to keep me right in the public eye.
It ought to keep you right in a public house. Actually, it reminds me of my Uncle Willie. Oh.
Your Uncle Willie, it would do, yeah.
Yeah, my Uncle Willie was preserved in stone, you know.
Was he? Did he do something outstanding?
No, he fell into a cement mixer.
Hey, Bernie, I remember that. That was in Ringwood Road, wasn't it?
Mm, yeah. Where was he buried?
Numbers 9, 11 and 13.
No, but it's my Uncle Willie all over.
Peter, we are only joking. Honestly, I think it's absolutely lovely.
It is, isn't it?
Yes, Peter, it does bring out your character.
Yeah, but what do you mean by that?
It proves you're two-faced.
Yeah. Oh. Peter, it's really you.
You think so?
The way they've got your features, the way they've got your smile.
You must admit it's classy, like the Sphinx upon the Nile.
They've even got your hooter right, it's sticking out of
mind. But it's you.
You think so?
This bust will make me famous, no matter where it's seen.
They'll put it up a crossroads where before the lights had been.
Your eyes directing traffic, this one red and this one green.
What do you mean?
But it's you.
Is it
you?
Really?
You.
It assures me of my place in history. Like old Moore and his almanac. Or the Mona Lisa smile of mystery.
And if no one comes to see it, he can always send it back.
Look what it did for Nelson.
Standing in Trafalgar Square.
But I can't stand heights, and think of all the pigeons flying there.
Yes, in a week or two, you should have silver in your hair.
Madame Tussauds.
Yeah, of course I am.
Adam Tussauds scarecrows.
Oh, it's you. You.
Thank you, Pete, Bernie and Jack and Bert Hayes and the boys. We come to the boys' game now. And who do we have over here?
Michael.
And who are you with this week?
Second Wing Green Cub Scout Pack.
Right. Oh, you said that beautifully. Michael, what's your name?
I'm Matthew.
You're Matthew?
Simon.
Simon.
Robert.
And Robert. And once again, we're making animal out of fruits, bananas this time. Over to you, Val.
Okay. Now, boys, if you watch closely, we're going to make a monster this time. We've got to get it standing again, so we put two legs on like that. That's easy enough. Then it'll stand up. And then we've got to give it some eyes, so we push a thing through there like that. Whoops, it doesn't want to stand up. With a couple of raisins for eyes, there and there. And then we do scales down the back of its, along its back. So you make four little slits down the back, and then you pop these almonds in, and then that looks sort of like a dragon with scales, if you do it right.
Thank you. Okay, lads, you think you can do that? Yeah, we'll give you 45 seconds to find out. Val, we'll have the marks from you later. So over this side, we've got Matthew here, Michael there, Simon's here, and Robert is down at the end here. All right? Ready for the whistle? Monster-making time. One leg, two legs. That's it, don't forget the eyes. That's right, get the holes in the back. This time we'll start with Matthew and a pretty good monster.
Well,
there.
I think that's a lovely monster.
Do you?
Yes, 17 for that.
17 for Matthew, that's good.
Yes.
My goodness me.
13 for this one, I think.
13 for yes. Michael's. So still Matthew in the lead. Here we come with Simon's.
Simon, I think 16 for that.
16, very close. Yes. And finally to Robert.
Well, shall we say 13 for that?
13. So that means Matthew's the winner! Well done, Matthew. That's it. There's Jan having a quick almond nut. Well done to Matthew, and thank you to Val Jackson for showing us how to make those animals from fruit. Right, time in the programme once again for our young entertainers. Thank you. Right, it's time to see who won last week's competition of young entertainers, and here he is like a marvellous canary this week, because he's wearing a beautiful yellow dressing gown.
Very nice.
Peter Glaze.
Yeah.
With the winner.
You want to see who won it?
I do. Okay. I don't know.
Well, last week's winner, Jacqueline Fisher, the impressionist from Birmingham area.
Well done to Jacqueline. Well, we're starting with the magician this week. She's representing the London area, so let's have a great welcome now for Stacey Lee. Do it. There's Stacey representing the London area. Up to the Glasgow area now for four singer guitarists by the names of Donna, Debbie, Denise, and Jackie. Well, now we're having two young lads. We haven't had puppeteers on the programme before. We're popping over to the Manchester area. And two puppeteers are Darren Brady and John Swindles.
Thank you.
Sharon Brady and John Swindles. We go now to the ventriloquist dummy of Sandra Scruton, who comes from Belfast.
And a thousand welcomes to Crackerjack!
Paddy, leprechauns are supposed to be lucky, aren't they?
Some luck. I got punished today at school because I thought they said you were smoking.
If the boy beside you was smoking, how come you get punished?
Because I was setting on fire. Did you hear about the Irishman? He wanted to drown at sea. No, what did I do? His three friends drowned, digging his grave. Did you hear about the Yank? He killed a tap dancer.
No, what about him?
He got washed down the sink. Well, we finish off with a song. Music Nostro, in the key of D flat. Here's a D. And we'll flatten it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want it short. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stand your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stand your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want it short.
Representing Belfast and over the sea to Scotland, representing the Aberdeen area, has a lovely singer called June McBain. Program, we come to our first semi-final. So let's hear it once again, so far, for all our young entertainers. And what a lovely crowd as well. Okay, to this week's film, and if you go walking in the park next time, beware of this lot.
Thank you.
Don't say I didn't warn you either. Thank you for our film for this week. Now to our very final game. We've got Matthews this side, Mandy this side. I'm lifting like that. But we've got a little final game. We've got a jigsaw of a face. The first one to guess the face and then burst the balloon will be the winner. Ready? On the whistle. Steady. See what you know. Valerie Singleton.
Radio cassette.
That's it. And one for you, Mandy, as well.
For you, Mandy, a cassette. Very well
okay.
Done.
Well How done to that? Our five listeners. What is finale time on Crackerjack? And back to Old Mexico for Viva Zapata.
I do not listen to Junior Choice anymore. Why? Oh. That record makes me sick. He plays it every day, and he brings the cockroaches out of the woodwork. Oh, here comes one now. It must be Gonzalez.
Oh. Hey, Rosita, caramba, be my gum. Come quick. Down at the post office, they're giving the green stamps with the TV license. I think.
You think? You always think. Why don't you do something? And look at the rim of your hat. It is all crumpled.
Oh, I soon fix that, if I go, caramba. I soon fix it. Hello! Ah, that fix it now. I think.
You think? Oh, please, why don't you do something?
Well, I will do something, but first of all, I must have a little think.
Well, do not bother to taxi your brain, because I have already sent for the Magnificent Seven.
You mean, Yul Brynner is coming here with 6 bald-headed men?
Oh, how is it you can be so stupid?
I practice every day.
Oh. Listen!
That is the band. They practice every day.
Oh, no, no, it's the Magnificent Seven, you fool. Oh, God. They are coming.
All right, I'm here.
Now, put that into the bridal suite.
Ah, bonnets, Duchess, senor. I am Juan, known to the poverty-stricken villages hereabouts as Juan of the Magnificent Seven.
Oh, welcome to our village, Juan. But should there not be 7 of you?
No, I am the only Juan.
And now, I think we must offer you some refreshment.
Ah, tequila is the only refreshment I require. There is only one way to drink the tequila.
Si,
I show you. First, the salt on the back of the head. Then the lemon. Then the tequila. That is the worst tequila I have ever tasted.
I think because that was paraffin. This is the tequila.
Ah, the tequila.
And this. Is the brush.
What is the brush for?
You will find out sooner or later.
The tequila.
Gonzalez!
Oh, senor, now you know what the brush is for.
You stupid peasants. You get me here to defend you against Zapata, and you do not reward me in the proper manner.
Ah, but, senor, we are so poor. We even rely on the mice to bring us the cheese.
Oh, what do you learn?
We keep our trap shut.
You will need more than a trap, senor, in order to catch Zapata. You will have to lie in ambush.
Oh, very good. I will go and find the ambush and lie in it.
Because you end up in the cantina, and if Zapata attack the village, Juan will need all the help he can get.
Yes, that is true, senora, that is true. We must muster everything we can. Where do you keep your arms?
Oh, we keep them up our sleeve.
And where do you keep your brains, in the seats of your pants?
Oh, he needs the weapons. Please go and get them, Gonzalez.
Oh, caramba, ribago.
Oh.
How did he become so stupid?
He practices every day.
Oh, I don't think he needs to practice very much. Oh. He's already stupid.
I'm so sorry.
Caramba, ribago. Here are your weapons, senor.
How can you protect yourself against the pater with rolling pins? What are you going to do? Roll him out and throw him in the oven?
Oh, no. Rosita, she very good shot with the rolling pin.
Yes.
Yeah? She won't shoot me with the rolling pin.
How do you shoot anybody with a rolling pin?
Oh, one day I'm cleaning it and it go off accidentally.
What was it loaded with? Rockets?
Oh.
Hey, Rosita, that's a good idea. We use your rocket for the weapon.
Oh, you are so stupid.
Oh, Rosita, look what you've done. You broke my hat, but I soon fix it, caramba. Here I go.
Oh, you are so stupid.
That soon fix it, I think.
Why don't you hoist a white flag and hand the village over to Zapata?
Oh, this we cannot do. This is why we send her for you, senor. Because you are the bravest. Uh-huh. You are the most fearless. You are the most,
cheapest.
That's it. That's it. Now, in order to defend you, I want gold. Gold, lots of gold.
Oh, senor, the only gold in the village is in my father's fillings.
Yes, senor. He have so many gold filling in his teeth, he sleep with his head in his safe.
Caramba!
But don't worry, senor. I have got the combination.
That is not enough gold, senor. I want gold, gold, lots of gold. It is either the gold or your life.
Oh, take my life, senor. I needed the gold.
Please, Gonzalez, go and get it.
Oh, caramba, my gold.
Oh, senora, you are indeed, indeed, wise as well as beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
If he gets the gold, I will save you.
Thank you.
Senor, here is all the gold we have in the village.
The gold, the gold. I am rich. Unlock the... You have the combination, huh?
Ah, si, senor. I have the combination.
By a foot.
No, he didn't. He hit me big toe. But we have the gold, the gold. Look, reach, reach. Reach beyond the